ladies and gentlemen. I'm Hong Chao-Fu from Polar Research Institute of China. It's my honor to represent present a proposal for establishing China-Iceland joint aurora observatory in Iceland. Since Sultan's introduction on the history, how the proposal was made. As I think this early phase is since Professor Peng Yang first visited Iceland and occurred in last August. And since readings, especially Dr. Thorsten's great effort for coordinate, Professor Guli and Mr. Hado, we together finished the proposal. And, so the Earth was just the amount the solar atmosphere and the solar particle and the magnetic field into the geo-environment through the polar region, so cause the aurora and the other very dramatic phenomena at the same time, cause space weather disasters. And so the aurora study and the magnetic benefit studies in polar region is very important. And of course, the coupling between the solar wind magnetosphere growth and the magnetosphere is remedied in the polar region. As Professor Yang mentioned, we have some Antarctic and Arctic observations already. In Dongshan Station, Fulton Station, Dome, and Yellow River Station, River Sound, and the Kecho Station, Longyearbyen, we in this place we are doing aurora observatories, and especially at Dongshan Station and the Yellow River Station, the both these two stations are conjugate, so it's very good for Casper aurora observation, especially Bayside aurora observation. This is the geospace observatory at the Dongshan Station, Antarctic. So this very nice part, nice building actually is the aurora observation also. So at Dongshan Station, we have lots of instruments. Here we show the inch diameter into sound. This inch diameter into sound and sub-down ultra-freedom. The ultra-freedom is a component of sub-down, the field view, just like this. So this was just the distribution 2 years ago, and the atmospheric digital sound also is for atmosphere. And this electronic circulation network, this triangle network also has function station. And of course, at Dongshan Station, we have lots of optical observations also, including the all-sky TV camera, mass scanning, photometer, and the spectrographer, and the images, and also the multi-wavelength all-sky images. This the different scale aurora images, so we can observe the different scale of aurora at the same time, and the multi-wavelength imager. I'm going to ask to observe the aurora in different waves. And we also have a spectrographer at Zhongshan Station, so we can observe the meridian aurora spectrum. And between Zhongshan Station and the Dong'e, the Zhongshan Station, we also have a magnetic interchange. And this optical operations at the Yellow River Station in Yunnan. So this also three buildings, all sky optical imager and spectrographer. And at Yellow River Station, we also have an imager, so it can observe the aurora precipitation at all. And at Longyearbyen K2O station, we also have a multi-frequency all sky imager, so you can see the observe aurora also at the place. And here, I'd like to introduce maybe very briefly about our recent studies about the aurora. The semantic studies of dayside aurora morphology and the spectrum. This result from Zhongshan Station's aurora morphology, especially for post phenomena. And this for synoptic studies of dayside aurora at the Yellow River Station. Also, this for dayside, this meter metric long, so this dayside aurora for different movements. And we can see there are some hot spots. This is very, very important for dayside aurora. And this different aurora regions, in fact, related with different magnetosphere development and activity in different regions. And we also studied the dayside shock aurora with the sudden commands of the storm. So it's just as a sudden commands time in the both Zhongshan Station, South Pole Station aurora, and also the Sukdang observations have a very quick response with this phenomenon. And also we studied the FTE, flux Tesla counter events, this very famous phenomena in magnetosphere with polar moving aurora forms, also with this aurora, and we also have some explain for this. Of course, subdome is very important for aurora, so we studied subdome with the satellite observations. This study for double break subdome in the North Pole. And we also used the magnetometer observations studying the subdome. Why we didn't study the subdome with ground optical observation? This, in fact, because the limits of our observation, both Zhongshan Station and the Yellow River Station is best for dayside aurora observation. On the other hand, the Iceland is a very good location for nightside aurora observation. And actually, the solar particle and the magnetic field energy entered from the dayside. Some of the energy were input into the atmosphere because dayside aurora, the most of the energy were going to the tail of the magnetosphere, and it caused very strong aurora. We call subzone aurora at night side. So the night side of aurora observation is very, very important. And here we show the satellite observations. This is the all, in fact, this coordinate is this dayside main side and this the neck tube. So we can see that the neck side particle precipitation is very strong, and unfortunately, all Zhongshan and Yellow River station is very good for this side, for this and this place of fishing. But for here, because this station is a little bit higher latitude, so this limitation of all established observation. Here we show the aurora over, and this green area is cooperating, and there are some, the black dots are the Zhongshan and the Yellow River stations one day shooting. So at daytime, at cooperating and into the aurora over, and then to the color in the forecast, and then into the aurora again. So both Zhongshan Station and Yellow River Station is very good for dayside of aurora observation. On the other hand, the red circle is excellent location, one day shooting under the aurora over. So during the night time, especially at this place is the subdome onset occurred, very frequent occurred region, the island just over this region. So it's very good for night side aurora observations. And of course, this subdome not only very fantastic, also sometimes cause some problem with example for the communication between satellite and the ground surface situation. And here we show the aurora, their time aurora over. Of course, on this this is Iceland and the Zhongshan Yellow River, this Yellow River station is around here, but it can, at the night time, the Iceland will be around this place, and the Yellow River station will be around this place. So both these two stations are very good to coordinate observation. So not only for scientific research, the aurora is very important. Also, aurora is a very fantastic phenomenon in northern and southern region, and is attracting most of tourists to visit this region. So, the aurora observatory will be very good for outreach for the public and especially for tourists. So we cooperate with the Archipelago and University of Iceland, of course, University of Akureyri, and this will be very good for outreach for the local and some middle native country peoples. And of course, this is also very good for NAPAS and FOCUS for some other users. So how to establish and operate the aurora observatory? Since last April, we have lots of discussion on the coordinate with readings. We were Science Institute of University of Iceland will be our scientific partner, and Archipelago will be logistic partner, and to support and manage the operation of aurora observatory. Of course, also a very good platform for the outreach for the whole world. not so complicated. It's just local, maybe not in Oakley, but some place outside Oakley. And of course, we an open field, so we can observe the all sky with optical vision and with less inference from other artificial lights. Of course, with power and internet access and not far from our neighborhood, so we can manage the observation more easily. Of course, in fact, the aurora is not this phenomena is related not only with optical, also some other phenomena we can with other radio and magnetic field observations to assist this observation. So we also need some flattened field for install this instrument. So the potential location, we have just found some potential location very close to Oakley. And in order to do the observation, we might need to build observatory building, maybe the main building of the retreat. We need some optical platform at the top. And some electronic platform, maybe we need some spare platform also. And of course, on the ground floor, we can have some laboratory and some storage. And the observational instruments, including the optical instruments, this has optical instruments just receive optical signal such as Oscar India, Aurora Spectra, and LB interferometer, and optical detection instruments such as NIDA, and passive electronic radio or magnetic field observation such as magnetometer, rheometer, GPS receiver, and microwave station via receiver, and active radio detection such as atmospheric digisound, and in the future we can also do some atmospheric investigation. So the timetable, it's quite depends on how it's going on. Anyway, we have some basic timetable. So from now on, we are in fact this we share with SNS this time. We already signed agreement between PIC and SI, and from then on. To next summer, we hope we can determine the location of the aurora observatory and to build optical observation buildings. And next fall, we can install some instruments and start the observation. And next, we hope we can install some other instruments to expand the. Observation capability. So in summary, aurora is an indicator and a very important phenomena in polar region. The geomagnetic location of Iceland is very ideal for aurora, especially for aurora subdome observation, where already have a very long history to observe aurora and attracts many people from all world to watch Northern Lights. We have established some aurora observations in polar regions, but many on dayside aurora. So to establish a joint a lot of territory in Iceland will benefit not only for scientific study, but also for public outreach and space weather prediction, not only for our best both sides, but also for all humans. So let's do it cooperatively.